Marco Rubio would be the nominee than even John Kasich. He's won more states. He still has more popular votes than John Kasich. But I think that's really sort of a Hail Mary, if you will, by people who don't like either of these candidates. I think it's either going to be Ted Cruz or it's going to be Donald Trump.
All right. Jennifer Rubin, opinion writer with The Washington Post. Thanks for the time.
My pleasure.
All right. Now we're going to turn to Katrina Pearson. She's the national spokesperson for the Trump campaign. Katrina, thank you for...
Hi, Steve.
Katrina, we are going to get back to you in one second. We said we're keeping an eye on Bernie Sanders. Let's listen in. I think he might be talking about last night.
Told CNN, and I quote, that their strategy as we go into New York and to Pennsylvania, I guess, is, quote, disqualify him, defeat him, and unify the party later. Now, you know, as I have said a million times, I have desired and I have run an issue-oriented campaign. Now, it's hard, as we can see here. The media is not particularly interested about why the middle class declines, about wage and income disparity. That's not what you're interested in. But we have tried in rally after rally, and many of you have been there, to talk about the most important issues facing the American people. But if Secretary Clinton thinks, you know, that just because I'm from a small state in Vermont, and we're going to come here to New York and go here to Pennsylvania, and they're going to beat us up and they're going to go after us in some kind of really uncalled for way, then we're not going to fight back. Well, we got another, you know, they can guess again, because that's not the case. This campaign will fight back. So when you have headlines in the Washington Post, quote, Clinton questions whether Sanders is qualified to be president, my response is, well, you know, if you want to question my qualifications, let me suggest this. That maybe the American people might wonder about your qualifications, Madam Secretary, when you voted for the war in Iraq, the most disastrous foreign policy blunder in the modern history of America. People might want to wonder about your qualifications when you supported virtually every trade agreement. Trade agreements which have cost the American worker millions of decent paying jobs. And the American people might want to wonder about your qualifications when you're spending an enormous amount of time raising money for your super PAC from some of the wealthiest people in this country and from the most outrageous special interest. I don't think I have to explain to the American people what Wall Street did to this economy. And yet, in her last filing report for her major super PAC, one of several, she raised $15 million from Wall Street. Are you qualified to be president of the United States when you're raising millions of dollars from Wall Street, an entity whose greed, recklessness, and illegal behavior helped destroy our economy? So look, let me be clear. This is not the type of politics that I want to get in. I know it's what the media loves. It is not the type of politics that I want to get in. But let me also be very clear. If Secretary Clinton thinks that I just come from the small state of Vermont, we're not used to this, well, we will get used to it fast. I'm not going to get beaten up. I'm not going to get lied about. We will fight back. But I do hope that we can raise the level. And I do hope that now and then the media will choose to talk about real issues. You got a real issue, Nancy? What do you got?
Just to clarify, if you think she's not qualified...
No, what I am saying... Did you hear what I just said is that she has attacked me for being unqualified. And if I'm going to be attacked for being unqualified, I will respond in kind. So
yeah,
I would
Bernie, you
get
tell
away from
him.
This. I do have respect for Secretary Clinton. I don't know who in a campaign comes up with these brilliant ideas. But all that I'm saying is I am not going to go into New York. You know, I know that they are getting nervous. They've lost 7 out of the last 8 caucuses and primaries. And I know every day they develop a new approach to the campaign. I gather their approach is again, this is a quote from CNN. Quote, disqualify him, defeat him, and unify the party later. That sounds to me like they're ready to run a very negative campaign. That is not what I want to do. I don't want to do that. But if we are going to be attacked in my qualifications for president after being in the Congress for 25 years, supporting working people throughout my entire career, standing up to virtually every special interest in this country, they're going to question my qualifications. I think I have a right to question this. Thank you all very, very much. And guys,
yeah.
Thank you very much for the fight.
Gary!
Okay, that was Bernie. Let the revolution start.
Labor group there. We said we were keeping an eye on whether he would elaborate on those comments he made last night about Hillary Clinton saying she's unqualified to be president. He stood by the remarks he made last night. He said, and this has been the dispute this morning, the dispute is last night, Sanders, before saying she was unqualified, had prefaced his comments by saying, she said, I'm unqualified. And then he said, let me tell you why she's unqualified. He is saying that the Clinton campaign told CNN that its strategy was to disqualify him, defeat him, and then unify the party. On that basis, he is saying at this event, he is now responding in kind. He said, she has attacked me for being unqualified, and if she attacks me for being unqualified, I will respond in kind. Sanders also added there, though, I do have respect for Hillary Clinton. Casey Hunt has been following Bernie Sanders, is in that room. So Casey Hunt, I'm trying to understand exactly what he's saying there, exactly what he's basing that on. He's saying, though, that she did call him unqualified. I'm still not clear that she actually did, though.